During the accession of the Crimean Peninsula in 2014 to Russia, the Ukrainian army was preparing a military operation to liberate the peninsula. The first deputy chief of the main operational directorate of the General Staff of Ukraine, Viktor Nazarov, told about it in an interview with Crimea Realia. The media outlet is included into the register of foreign agents media by the Minister of Justice of Russia. He was part of a military delegation that arrived in Crimea in 2014. We took the combat readiness documents with us. So what was the idea? Bring the command of the naval forces and the subordinate unit to full combat readiness for verification purposes. And then, in the next step, bring the real one into combat readiness. Then, withdraw the military units, prepare them, withdraw the ships from the bases and, at least, anchor them somewhere so that they are not then blocked. The general said that they had every chance to retain Crimean airfields and other strategic facilities. However, at the very last moment, the head of the General Staff of Ukraine, Mikhail Kutsin, shut down the operation. The reasoning was that the situation was already very tense, it was not necessary to strain it even more. Enough, tell everyone to stand down, return them, and don't send anyone. Send planes back to airfields, units back to barracks. We're done. In addition, Nazarov accused the leadership of the SBU, the Ministry of Internal Affairs, the Border Service and the Prosecutor's Office of inaction at this fateful moment for the country. I said, wait, let's keep working. Then we called all these representatives of the SBU, the Ministry of Internal Affairs, Border Guards and the Prosecutor's Office. Then they said, there is nothing we can do, we have nothing to do with this. I concluded that they all went completely into denial. There are no active measures, we can do nothing. In fact, the seizure has already happened. No de jure, de facto happened. Then, they report to me that the measures to combat readiness have been cancelled. Crimea became part of Russia in March 2014, after a referendum. We stand against the background of the flags of the Russian Federation, which demonstrate the unity of our country. This line will be replenished today with two new flags. Crimea and Sevastopol. More than 96% of the region's residents and 95.6% of Sevastopol voters spoke in favor of joining. My spirit soars, soul sings that we are with Russia. Before the voting, there were armed men in military uniform on the peninsula, who were called polite people. Putin later admitted that those were the Russian military. Ukraine considers the entry of Crimea into Russia illegal. Kyiv calls the peninsula occupied territory. Western countries also do not recognize Crimea as Russian. After the referendum, the United States and EU countries imposed sanctions against Russia. On March 11th, the National Security and Defense Council of Ukraine adopted a strategy for deoccupation and reintegration of Crimea, which Foreign Minister Dmitry Kuleba, on his Twitter page, called historic and outlined three main points of its implementation. Three pillars for the return of Crimea. Strategy, approved today. Consolidation, we are working to unite the efforts of all partners on the Crimean platform. Synergy, restoration of international law and, as a result, restoration of full sovereignty of Ukraine over Crimea and the city of Sevastopol. President Vladimir Zelensky, following a meeting of the National Security Council, promised that he would never forget about the loss of Crimea and deal with those who created all the conditions for this. To those who counted on something, I can say, don't even think that Ukraine will forget about Crimea. At the same time, when we are talking about deoccupation, it is also logical to understand who and how created the conditions for occupation. And we are talking not only about 2014, but also about the adoption of the so-called Kharkov Agreement. The world has already reacted to the statement of Ukrainian politicians. Chairman of the Estonian Parliament Committee on International Affairs, Marko Mikkelson, promised that their country would help Ukraine return Crimea. Crimea is Ukraine. Estonia will never recognize the illegal annexation of Crimea by Russia and will work to ensure that international law and human rights pave the way for the deoccupation of Crimea. This requires international cooperation, consistency and, of course, relentless lobbying of Ukraine itself. Russian politicians also responded to Ukraine's plans to return the peninsula. Sergei Tsakov, a member of the Federation Council Committee on International Affairs from the Republic of Crimea, called the strategy another empty statement, and the State Duma deputy from Crimea, Ruslan Balbek, said that the work of Ukraine to return the region is a Sisyphean labor.